As most of the Northern Hemisphere baked under a prolonged heatwave this summer, Greenland was hit with an unusual late-season heatwave and melt event in early September, the kind of melt that usually occurs in the middle of summer. Today we take a closer look at some of the melt ponds in the province of Avannaata in Greenland. Welcome to Earth from Space. Melt ponds are vast pools of open water that form on both sea ice and ice sheets. When snow and ice melts atop glaciers, water flows in channels and streams and collects in depressions on the surface. These melt ponds can speed up the melting of the surrounding ice since they greatly reduce the ice's ability to reflect sunlight. In this image, melt ponds can be easily spotted from space, as they are usually much darker than the surrounding ice. In some ponds, chunks of ice float atop the pond's waters. The bay visible here is Sugarloaf Bay, an indentation of the northeast Baffin Bay in the Upper Narvik Archipelago. The archipelago extends from the northwest coast of Sugupnuna Peninsula to the southern end of Melville Bay. The Greenland ice sheet is the largest ice mass in the Northern Hemisphere. It extends over 2,000 kilometers north to south, with an average thickness of around 1,500 meters. The first day of September typically marks the end of the Greenland melt season, as the sun moves lower in the sky, with temperatures usually cooling. However, at the beginning of September 2022, temperatures began to rise again when a strong air pressure parked at the southeast edge of Greenland and drew warmer air northwards across Baffin Bay and the west coast of Greenland. This led to meltwater runoff, the amount of surface water entering the ocean, to increase, with its extensive melting contributing to global sea level rise. This impacts millions of people living in coastal communities around the world. In a recent paper published in Nature Climate Change, scientists found that major sea level rise from the melting of the Greenland ice cap is now inevitable, even if the burning of fossil fuels were to halt overnight. Earth observation satellites are key to monitoring ice, as they carry instruments that measure changes in the thickness of the ice sheets, fluctuations in the speed of the outlet glaciers, and even small changes in Earth's gravity field caused by melting ice, as well as sea level rise.
Thank you.